Good morning, students, and welcome to the classes of costing and taxation. We had started costing and we were doing chapter 1, cost of materials, and we had learned in the first class that there are four methods of valuation of materials, and in the last class we solved an example under the FIFO method, first in first out method. Now the main practical aspect of this chapter is making a stores ledger under which we calculate the amount at which the goods are issued and the closing stock or the balance of goods that is left after the end of the month. That is the main thing that we have to do in this chapter. So in the last class we solved an example under the FIFO method. In today's class, we'll be solving an example under the LIFO method. LIFO method means last in, first out. This method is the exact opposite of the FIFO method, that is first in, first out. What do we do in the LIFO method is that the goods that are purchased recently, those goods are sold first. Suppose I am a trader and I buy goods and sell them. Simple. So on 1st January, I purchased some goods. I purchased 200 units. And on 3rd January, I purchased 400 units. 200 units was purchased for 1 rupees and 400 units was purchased for 2 rupees. Now on 5th, on the 5th of January, what happened? I issued some goods. I issued 300 units. Let's look at this example then. I'm a trader and on 1st January, I purchased goods for 1 rupees. On 2nd Jan, I purchased 400 at 2 rupees. On 5th Jan, what happened? I sold 300 units. Now this 300 units will be issued at what rate? This will be my task to calculate. So under the LIFO method, what happens? Whatever goods have been purchased in the latest, those will be sold first. Those units or those goods will be sold first. So in this case, the goods that was purchased by me in the latest date was 2nd January, 400 units at 2 rupees. Therefore, on 5th January, the goods that I will sell 300 units will be from this one and not from this one. So 300 units have been sold from this stock at 2 rupees. Right, then again on 6th January, what I do, I again sell 200 units. Right, I have already sold 300 units. Right, I had 200 plus 400, I had 600 units in total. I had already sold 300 units, I was left with 300 units. Right, in total, 300 units in total. This 300 units comprise. Listen to me carefully. This 300 units comprised of 200 units at 1 rupees and how much? 100 units at 2 rupees. Rupees 1, rupees 2. Right? After issuing goods on 5th January, I was left with how much? 300 units. 300 units out of which 200 was left from the beginning and then 100 was left from here, the later stock. Now if I am purchasing here again, issuing again 200 units here, I'll take 100 units from this one, right? Because this one is the latest good. This stock is the latest stock. I take 100 units from here and 100 units from here. 2 rupees 1 rupees, total 300. So this is the LIFO method. If you haven't understood, we'll solve an example, and I hope you will understand in that example. So let's solve this example. On February 1, what happened? There was an opening balance of 800 units at rate 10 rupees. Then on Feb 4, goods were purchased 300 units, and on Feb 10, issues were made. So let's start the sums. And again, I apologize for my handwriting, but please. So Feb 1, there was opening stock, so no issues, balance of how much? It was, I think, 800 units at 10 rupees. So 8000, simply multiply, you will understand. Please stay with me, and if you don't understand, then tell me. Feb 4, purchase was made. How much? 300 units. Feb 4, 300, right? At what rate? 11.25. So 300 into 11.25 is equal to 3375. No issues was made. So I have goods balance will be 800 and 300. 800 at 10 rupees and 300 at 11.25 rupees. 800 into 10, 8000, and 300 into 11.25 is equal to 3375. Add them, the total is 11375, since I don't have space. So, and the total number of goods units was 1100. Okay, you please do it neatly in your copy. Now what happened? Now the real part of sums comes in. Issues on Feb 10, issues were made. How much? 1000 units. Feb 10, no receipt, only issues. How much? 1000, right? Now this is last in first out method. Now the total amount of goods that I have to issue is 1000. Now look over here, how much units do I have in total? In total I have 1100 units. So in order to issue this 1000, first I will take 300 units at the rate of 11.25, because this was purchased latest, right? And then I will take how much? 700 units at the rate of 10. That's it. Are you being able to understand? Please send me your energy through your mobile phones and say yes sir, thank you so much. So 300 units have been purchased from the latest stock, issued from the latest stock, and then the rest 700 have been purchased from this stock. This was opening stock, right? So we write over here 300 at 11.25. This is last in first out. This is what? Last in first out. So therefore this stock has been issued first, and then 700 at the rate of 10 rupees. So 300 into 11.25 is equal to 3375, and 700 into 10 is equal to 7000. So the total is 10375. This is the total issues made. So now how much goods are we left with? Simple, right? This 300 was issued, so this 300 has been exhausted, finish. And out of 800 we issued how much? 700 units. So how much is left?
100,
right? Please, I hope you are being able to understand. And at the rate of how much? 10. So means 1000 amount is left. Now let's move on to the sum. What happens on Feb 14, Valentine's Day, goods were purchased 1400 units at the rate of 11.40. So Feb 14, what happens? Purchases were made. Feb 14, how much? 1400, right? Yes, 1400 at the rate of 11.40. 11.40. So 1400 into 11.40 is equal to 15960. Issues nothing. Now let's record the balance. 100 at the rate of 10 and 1400 at the rate of 11.40. This will be 1000. This will be 15960. Total will be 16960. Okay, till here it is clear. Now what happens? Obviously, issues will be made after purchase. The gift has been purchased on Feb 14 and it will be given on Feb 16, 950 units. So let's do it. Feb 16. Feb 16. Issues were made. How much? 950. So let's make a working column again. 950 units, right? Total I have to issue 950 units. Now this is the LIFO method. Last in, first out. Whatever has been purchased in the latest will be sold first. So in the latest we have purchased this 1400 units, right? So the whole 950 units will be issued at the rate of 11.40. Simple. Why? Because I have enough number of units to issue from. Here we did not have enough number. Here I had to issue 1000, right? So we took 300 from here and 700 from here. Here I have to issue only 950 and I already have 1400 units of the stock, the latest stock. So 950 will be issued at whole 11.40. The whole 950 units will be issued at the rate of 11.40. So this has become very easy for us. Whole 950 units at 11.40. 950 into 11.40 is equal to 10830. Now the balance. How much do we have left? From here, 100 units is intact. Nothing has happened. No one has touched those 100 units. And from this one, from here, what happens? 950 units is deducted. So 1400 minus 950 is the number of units that is left. So 450 units are left from here. 10 rupees and 11.40 rupees. 1000 and 450 into 11.40, 5130. So the total will be 6130. Okay, and here 450. Okay, so I have this much of stock left on Feb 16. Now if you see, if you want to confirm, you subtract this from this. 16960 minus the number of the amount of issues made, 10830, should be equal to 6130. Now after Feb 16, what happens? One purchase and one issue has been made. So just let's record the purchase fast. On Feb 24, 700 at 11.60. At Feb 24, 700 units. 700 at 11.60. 700 into 1.60. 11.60. 8120. Nothing on in under issues. We'll write nothing under issues. And here we'll record the balance. See, the balance we had. First, we had 100 units of the previous stock. Yes, so 100 units from the previous stock we had. Then we had 450 from here. And now again, what happened? 700 units have been purchased. 700. So 100 is rate was 10. 450 rate was 11.40. And the new stock, the newest stock, 700 units rate is 11.60. So the amount of all three, 1,000, 5130 and 8120. 1,000 plus 5130 plus 8120. 14250. The only the last step of the sums is left. Please be with me. Thank you so much for being here so long. All the students who have been listening to me, and I have been trying to teach you so hard. Thank you for being with me. Only the last step is left. The issues. Feb 25. No receipt. Only issues was made. How much? 800 units, right? So again, right over here, 800. And 800 will be first issued from where? From this one. From 700 units, right? So 700 at 11.60. And how much is left? Only 100. Because we have to issue only 800 units. So this 100 will be taken from this one. This stock. The last stock. Okay, so 100 at 11.40. So 700. 700 at the rate of 11.60. And 100 at the rate of 11.40. 8120 and 1140. 8120 plus 1140 is equal to 9260. Now let's see how much stock do we have left. The total stock that was left before this issue was 100 plus 450 plus 700. There was, we had 1250 units left with us. Now after the issues made, we have 1250 minus 800. We have only 450. Okay. And this 450, we have 100 stock from here at 10 rupees and 350 from this one. 350 from this one, right? We had issued only 100 units from here. So 450 minus 100 is equal to 350. So 350 into 11.40, 1000 units, and 350 into 11.40, 3990 plus 1000, 4990. So my closing stock is 4990. So this was the whole sum. Pretty exhaustive and tiring, but thank you so much for listening, the students who have listened. And today also no homework for my good students. Please practice this sums only. Practice it one time, two time. And thank you so much for attending this class, because it takes a lot of time and effort to make these videos so that you all can understand it. And if there is any query, and I'm sure people will have query, then please feel free to ask to me at my email ID. You know that. Thank you so much for today, and that will be all. Have a very nice weekend.